channel, please share it with your near and dear.
Let's go for must. Must for necessity, number one. Okay, must for necessity or a wish. Structure is here, subject plus mustn't plus V1. Subject plus must or mustn't plus V1. So this is the structure. Right, let me give examples. After giving all examples, I will explain these things to you. Right, examples here. And let me give examples for this. Must for certainty, negative of must is can't. Okay, structure is here. Now let me explain. Must for necessity or a wish, especially must is used for personal feelings, not rules. They don't talk about must is used for personal feelings, not for rules. So, as per that, must for necessity or a wish. It is used for necessity. It is necessary for some person to say like that. We use the subject plus must or mustn't plus V1. Right. You must work hard to get a job. Means it is necessary for you to get a job. Necessity, we are talking about necessity. You must work hard to get a job. They must learn English. It is necessary for them to learn English. To get a job or to do anything also, it is necessary for them. So, to indicate the necessity of something for person, for a person or for people, we can use must. They must learn English. And wish also sometimes. Sometimes we express wishes also with the must. I mustn't eat too much today. It's my wish. I mustn't eat too much today. It expresses wish of a person. Means of the same person who says. I must wake up early today. Means it's my wish to wake up early today. So, when I express my wish to do something also, we use must. So in this way, for necessity or a wish, we use a must or mustn't. Okay? Then must for certainty. And negative form of must is can't. Okay, subject must or can't plus be or have or no, etc. Right, you must, especially we are talking about, you see, after must or can't, be. Right, you must be tired now. When I observe him, he seems to be very much tired. Then I can say, you must be tired now, it is better for you to go to bed. When I want to suggest him to go to bed, I can even say in this way, you must be tired now. You must be tired now. It is certain that you are tired. Okay? And he must be intelligent. So he has got a job. He has got a job means here it is certain that he is an intelligent. When we feel certain that something is possible, then we use this must. Okay, he must be intelligent, so he has got a job. He has just eaten. He can't be hungry now. Can't be. He has just eaten. He has eaten just now only. So there is no chance for him to eat again now. That's why we can say he can't be hungry now. Subbu can't be at his house at this time because his regular time is different. His regular time is something fixed. As per that, Subbu can't be at his house at this time. At this particular time, he can't be at his house. Generally, he is out at this time. And to say that it is certain to be like that, we use can't. And if she belongs to our colony, if she belongs to our colony, I must know her. I must know her. Means, it is certain that I know her. If she belongs to the belongs to our colony. And in the same way, he is from English medium background. If he is really from English medium background, then we feel it is certain that he has communication skills in English. That's why we use he must have good communication skills in English. Okay, as we feel certain to have such qualities, we use must. So in these two ways, we use must in our day-to-day life. Now we are going to learn how to use has or have to. Has or have to are will or shall have to may or might have to. May or might have to. Okay, these are the modal verbs we are going to learn today. So far we have learned many modal verbs like can, could, may, might, shall, should. Okay, such a way. And in the same way, has to, have to, will have to, shall have to, may have to, might have to, has to or have to, we are going to learn today. Okay. And especially these structures, these expressions are used only when a situation, when a situation or a rule when a situation or rule makes something necessary. When a situation or a rule makes something necessary, we use it. And we don't use it for we don't use them for personal feelings. Okay, we don't use them for personal feelings. Right, okay. Now let us learn how to use them. Okay. And after giving some examples and after that, okay, I'll talk about all these things also. Right, okay. So what is the situation or what is a rule and what is personal feeling? To make it clear to you, I'll give some examples, okay? For example, you see here, personal feeling. Okay, now, okay, let me explain first this one. Has or have to. If subject is singular, has, plural, have, and in the case of I also have, then 2 plus V1, will or shall have plus 2 plus V1, may or might have plus, might have 2 plus V1, and these three structures are used mainly when a situation or rule makes something necessary. So we use these structures for necessity only. But what type of necessity? When a situation makes it necessary, we have to use. Or when a rule makes it necessary, we have to use. Not for personal feelings. For personal feelings, necessity for personal feelings, we use must. We use must for personal feelings in the sense of necessity. But in the sense of same necessity, not for personal feelings, We have to use has to, have to, will have to, shall have to, may have to, might have to. When situation or rule makes something necessary only, we have to use these structures. So, but what are personal feelings and what are situations and what are rules now? Let me explain this to you so clearly. Personal feeling. For example, doctor says to Ravi, this way, you have to take a walk every day. So it is doctor's personal feeling. Doctor's personal feeling it is. So according to doctor, you see the doctor himself, you have to take a walk every day. So doctor personal feeling is that Ravi has to take a walk every day. This is personal feeling of doctor. Right. So here, here you should not use have. You should use here, we must use here must. And sorry. So here we have to use the must. As it is personal feeling, we have to use you must take a walk. You must take a walk every day. You must take a walk every day. So must is used for personal feeling. And situation here. But Ravi says to his friend, Ravi tells his friend, I have to take a walk every day. So here this is situation according to doctor's suggestion, not his personal feeling. It is not Ravi's personal feeling. So as situation needs, he has to take a walk every day. So when he says, I have to take a walk every day, this indicates the situation. According to the suggestion of doctor, he has to take a walk every day. So this comes under situation, but this comes under personal feeling. When it is personal feeling, we have to use must. When it is situation, we have to use have to or has to. Or in the same way, will have to or shall have to, may have to or might have to also. As per situation, we have to use. And rule. So when rule also makes something necessary, we have to use have to or has to or may have to, might have to, shall have to, will have to. Not must. One has to keep left on the road. One has to keep left on the road. According to traffic rule, every person has to keep left on the road. This is rule. When we talk about rule also, when we talk according to situation also, we have to use these three structures, not must. Must is used only for personal feelings. But must also talks about necessity. These three structures also talk about necessity. But there is difference. Okay, now let us come to examples part.
Thank you for watching this channel. We'll meet in the next episode.